So the other day, the scripture came to me where I think it's Paul who says, my God, who, and I think this is the Amplified, it might not be exactly correct, but this is how I remember it. My God, who liberally provides all my needs, wants, and desires, shall provide all your needs, wants, and desires according to his riches in glory. Now that's a big statement. And the Lord's really been challenging me with that. I heard Jesse Duplantis say quite some time ago that he always responds with all my needs are met. And he's been teaching his little granddaughter to say that, all my needs are met. And it's like, wow, and they are. And I think too often we go into this need-based place when God says, wait, wait a minute, all your needs are met, partner with me, and you'll not only get your needs, but your wants and your desires as well. The interesting thing is, he spoke to me today. He said, if it is not what you want to happen, don't say it. Just don't say it. Because the enemy is all about bringing thoughts to us. And what you think about is what you're going to say. And I like to liken it. Most body people who are training you to get fit, et cetera, will say 70 to 80% of getting fit is what you put in your mouth, is what you eat. Only 20 or 30% is actually what you do or how you work out. So the large percentage of it, especially if you want great abs, it's 70 to 80% of it. This one young lady who's a trainer says 70 to 80% of having great abs is in the kitchen. And in fact, most of great abs are in the kitchen. And so the Lord's really been challenging me that if it's not something you want to happen, don't say it. And to really be very mindful of the fact that he is always meeting all your needs, wants, and desires.